Hello guys, today I'll show you how to make exact 1 Hz frequency generator with crystal oscillator. So let's get started. To generate accurate 1 Hz clock frequency, I'll use crystal oscillator because it generates a signal with precise frequency. I'm using a 32.768 kHz crystal oscillator, or you can say it 32,768 Hz. Now see here. Now our aim is to get 1 Hz clock frequency. So we'll divide its frequency with 32,768 with frequency divider, and we'll get 1 Hz frequency. Now the frequency divider, I am going to use the IC4060. Now let's see the pin diagram of IC4060. Here is pin number 1, pin number 8, pin number 9, pin number 16. Pin number 8 is connected to ground, 16 is connected to plus 5 volt. Pin number 12 is reset pin, and normally we connect this pin to ground. Pin number 11, 10 and 9 for the input clock signal. Okay, and rest of the pins is output. Pin number 1 is Q12, pin number 2 is Q13, 3 is Q14, pin number 4 is Q6, Q5, Q7, Q4, and pin number 13 is Q9, 14 is Q8, and pin number 15 is Q10. Now here Q4 means 2 to the power 4. 2 to the power 4, it means 16. So whatever the input frequency is, it will divide by 16. If you connect your output to Q7, that means 2 to the power 7, and 2 to the power 7 is equal to 128. So whatever the input frequency is, it will divide by 128. Okay, so like this, other pin also. Q10 means 2 to the power 10, and 2 to the power 10 is equal to 1024. Now see, if your input frequency is 1024 Hz, then you are going to divide with Q10, then your output frequency will be 1 Hz. So like this, we can divide our input frequency with this IC. Now see here carefully. Here our input frequency will be 32,768 Hz, because we are going to use this oscillator and its frequency is 32,768. So to get 1 Hz frequency, so we have to divide it by 32,768 so that we will get 1 Hz frequency. But you can see here the maximum value we have is Q14. That means 2 to the power 14 is equal to 16,384. So with this IC, we can get up to 2 Hz, because this number is just double of this. If you divide our input frequency with this number, that is 2 to the power 14, we will get 2 Hz. So we need 2 IC like this. Okay, now see the calculation carefully. Our input frequency is this. Okay, and this equal to 2 to the power 15. So anyhow, we have to make it Q15. In this IC, we have up to Q14. Now we have to see one combination which equal to Q15. See here Q5 and here Q10. If you take the combination Q5 and Q10, you will get Q15. Or you can say it is Q7 here, that is pin number 6, and here Q8, that is pin number 14. So if you take the combination pin number 6 and pin number 14, then also you are getting Q15. Or you can take pin number 4 and pin number 13, so that you will get Q6 plus Q9, it will be equal to Q15. Now let's say we are going to use Q7 and Q8. So we can write Q7 means 2 to the power 7 multiplied by Q8, it means 2 to the power 8. So it equal to 7 plus 8, 2 to the power 15. Okay, so like this we are getting this number. Okay, now let's see the circuit diagram, how we can combine these two pin number 6 and pin number 14. Like I said, we need two IC. Our input frequency is 32,768 Hz and we need 1 Hz frequency. So with these two IC, we have to divide it by 32,768. Okay, as I have explained here, first we will divide it by 2 to the power 7, that is Q7, and Q7 means pin number 6. Okay, now first let us complete all the basic connection, that is pin number 16 goes to plus VCC for both the IC, pin number 8 and 12 together goes to ground. Okay, now as I have explained in this, that pin number 9, 10 and 11 are used for input clock signal. So here pin number 9, 11 and 10, okay, these three pin, 9, 10 and 11, and the crystal oscillator is connected between pin number 9 and 11. This is the symbol of crystal oscillator, and in between pin number 11 and 10 we have to connect one resistor and its value is 330 kilo ohms. For the second IC we do not need this, just we need the input clock signal, the pin number 11. Now see here, first we are going to divide it with Q7, that is 2 to the power 7, it means pin number 6. So its pin number 6 is connected to pin number 11 of second IC. Now our second pin will be 2 to the power 8, that is Q8, and Q8 is pin number 14. So we will take output from pin number 14 and it will be equal to 1 Hz. So this is the very easy circuit. Now let's come to the breadboard connection, and here I am applying 5 volt. Okay, and with pin number 14 I am going to use a LED so that we can detect it. It is like 220 ohms. Okay, putting our crystal oscillator. Okay, it is very small actually, 4060, second 4060 IC. Pin number 16, it goes to positive rail. For this IC also, pin number 8 is connected to ground. For this IC also, pin number 12 is connected to ground, the reset pin. Okay, so power connection is completed. Now let's connect the crystal connection. The crystal do not have the polarity, so you can use it both the way. I'm connecting this pin to pin number 11, and another pin of crystal is connected to pin number 9. 330 kilo ohm resistor is connected between pin number 11 and 10. So this is pin number 10 and this one is pin number 11. Okay, it is connected. Now we are going to connect Q7, that is pin number 6. So here is our pin number 6, and now this pin is connected to input frequency pin of second IC, that is pin number 11. Okay, now put the output. Here I have put it, the output. Connect one resistor with it. Now we will take output from pin number 14, that is Q8, and it is connected to the LED or resistor, and another pin of the LED is connected to ground. So our breadboard connection is completed. Now connect the power supply. Here our positive and negative, turning on the power supply. Now it is blinking, but we don't know how accurately it is blinking. So we have to check it whether it is exactly 1 Hz or not. Now to check it whether it is exactly 1 Hz or not, I'm going to connect my oscilloscope here to ground, and I'm connecting with it, and I'm connecting my oscilloscope with output. Okay, see, it is showing here it is exactly 1.000 Hz. Okay, see, it is 1.000 Hz. Now see one more thing here, you can achieve 1 Hz by 14060 IC and 14017. With this 4017 IC, you can divide it, you can divide one frequency by 2. So if you take its output Q14 and one pin of IC 4017, then you will achieve Q15, that is 2 to the power 15, because it is 2 to the power 14, that means 2 to the power 14 multiplied by 2 is equal to 2 to the power 14 plus 1, that is 2 to the power 15. I'll show you how to do this. Before that, just see the pin diagram of 4017 IC. It is ground and it is plus 5 volt. Okay, and I have explained the 4017 IC in other video. Just check it. Take the output from pin number 2. Okay, and pin number 4 is connect to pin number 15. Okay, and just connect pin number 13 to ground, and pin number 14 is clock input, and the output from IC 4060 and this output, that is pin number 3, it means Q14, is connect to pin number 14 of IC 4017. Then we will take output from pin number 2. Just see the circuit diagram. This time one IC will be 4060 and another IC will be 4017. Then pin number 16, 8, 12, it is connected to plus VCC. 8 and 12 is connected to ground. Here it is pin number 16 is plus VCC. Pin number 8 and 13 is connected to ground. 9, 11, 10, this connection will be same like before, it is 330 kilo ohms. Then the pin number 3 means it is Q14. Okay, the Q14 is connect to its clock input, that is pin number 14 of IC 4017. Then we will take output from pin number 2, and this will be 1 Hz. Just see this in the breadboard. Now I am removing the previous 4060 IC, and this connection will be same as before. I am putting 4017 IC. Pin number 16 is connected to plus VCC. Pin number 8 is connected to ground. Pin number 4 and 15 are connected together. We'll take output from pin number 2, then the pin number 3 of IC 4060, and it is connected to pin number 14 of IC 4017. Now it will divide by 2, and it is dividing by 2 to the power 14, that is total of 2 to the power 15. If you do not have 2 pieces of IC 4060, then you can use this method. Here the pin number 13 is connected to ground. So our breadboard connection is completed. Now let's check it. Here is positive. Here is our ground. Now let's check it on oscilloscope. Here my ground, and I'm connecting oscilloscope at the output pin. See, it is also 1.000 Hz with 50% duty cycle. Okay. So guys, this is all for today. I hope you like this video. If so, then please like, share and subscribe to my channel. And if you have any doubt on this, then please let me know in the comment section. In the next video, I'll show you another topic. Till then, stay happy and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.